What is going on, guys? It's Fantastic Films here today, and I am back with my Blu-ray collection for 2019. Guys, this has been a while since I talked to you. It's been about a month. Weird looking at a camera. Taking the month off, you know, from like, I think at last time I posted was a couple days before Christmas. And since then, I've just kind of been getting stuff together with me, you know, working at me, just enjoying life without filming everything. I figured there's no better way to start off my, like, comeback, I guess, rather than doing a Blu-ray collection 2019, which will probably boost my views, hopefully. Make sure to like this video. Hope you guys enjoy this video, and stay tuned for the end for some quick announcements about the future of the channel. Alright guys, so to start off, my tripod actually doesn't go this high, so I'm just doing this part handheld, but it's gonna be really quick. I'm just gonna show you all the stuff I have up top here. So starting off on the far left, we have one of my favorite movies of all time, The Shawshank Redemption on VHS. It's amazing. Gone with the Wind, which I have yet to see, but it's a really nice VHS box set. The original Star Wars trilogy, unfortunately, they're the special editions, but I wore out these VHS tapes as a kid. I absolutely loved them. Some of my favorite movies of all time. We got Casablanca, also one of my favorite movies of all time, and this is a really nice box set. And I actually keep the Blu-ray in my shelf, but I kept the box up here. And if you can see there, it's the 70th anniversary, and it's a certain number out of 81,000, which is really, really cool. And then we got Ben-Hur, a movie I've been wanting to check out for a while, and this box set, I've been seeing it around the store I get my movies at, Bull Moose, for the longest time. So I finally bought it, and this is also a limited edition out of 125,000, which is really, really cool. Then we got the Star Trek, the 5-movie collection, the originals. It's the 25th anniversary collector's edition on VHS. Those are all pretty good. Some of them are like okay, but most of them are really good in my opinion. VHS for Braveheart, another really great film, and of course the original Jurassic Park, one of my favorite films of all time. Also, real quick guys, I actually have some movies downstairs which I will show you after I get through these shelves up here. Those movies are all movies that I just haven't gotten around to seeing yet, and I realized after a while I was just collecting a bunch of movies on my shelf that I hadn't seen, so I separated them. So now I'm working my way through that stack, trying to see as many movies that I haven't seen as I can. But anyway, without further ado, let's get to it. So the way I have it set up is very simple. I organize movies all the time. Sometimes I have the steelbook set out, the box sets, and right now I currently have all the box sets set aside from everything. Steelbooks are all mixed in, Criterions are all mixed in, and then the real things I have separated, I have my Lord of the Rings, like Middle Earth collection here, and then I also have the MCU films and the DC films. So, because those are all like some of my favorite movies, so I figured I'd just separate them off, but order will probably change literally like today or tomorrow. It's ridiculous, I spend way too much time here. But anyway, I have the, I'm not gonna pull this one out, this one is like really big. But it's the Lord of the Rings Motion Picture Trilogy Extended Edition. This is honestly one of my favorite box sets I've ever had. Such an amazing box set. Then here, I have The Hobbit, The Unexpected Journey. I also really love the Hobbit films. A lot of people give them crap, but I personally enjoy them a lot. The Desolation of Smaug, a really great film. And these are all extended editions, by the way. And then, actually, unpopular opinion, but my favorite Hobbit film, The Battle of the Five Armies. I absolutely love this film. Really underappreciated, in my opinion. Then we have, this is what goes inside the box set here, Lord of the Rings, The Fellowship of the Ring. I actually haven't seen the extended editions yet. I will. It's just, they're like literally 4 hours each, so I'm really excited to check them out. The Two Towers used to be my favorite, but now my new current favorite of the entire series. The Return of the King, such an amazing film. I'm so glad it won Best Picture. It's so rare for a film like this to win Best Picture. Then we got the Steelbook of The Fellowship of the Ring. Obviously, you can tell I like these movies a lot. Then we have The Two Towers here. Again, used to be my favorite. Now it's The Return of the King, which is this one right here. Oops, I just knocked down my little dwarf. This little guy here, he's supposed to be Gandalf, but he's not actually. In reality, I got this from my cousin from Norway a while ago, and it's just been sitting on my drawer, and I've never really known what to do with it. And then I thought, oh hey, I'm nerding out, it looks like Gandalf, so now he's here, and he is guarding my Middle-Earth collection, so don't mess with this gnome. Next, we have my MCU collection. So starting off, unfortunately, this border, like I have borders going down the entire shelf, so those get in the way, so I'll just take the first one out and then leave it out. We got Iron Man, the one that started it all, such an amazing film by Jon Favreau. The Incredible Hulk, really underrated in my opinion. Iron Man 2, probably my least favorite, or second to least favorite actually. Thor, the original. Captain America, the First Avenger. This actually was the movie, kind of like Signs, also in 310 Yuma, that really got me into movies. Then we have the original Avengers, such an amazing film. Then we have Iron Man 3, actually really like that one. Thor, the Dark World. Captain America, the First Avenger, or Winter Soldier, my bad. Guardians of the Galaxy, one of my favorite MCU films, and just one of my favorite films in general. Avengers Age of Ultron, wasn't a huge fan, but it's not terrible. Ant-Man, the original. Doctor Strange. Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2, this is actually my least favorite MCU film out of the entire series. Then we have Spider-Man Homecoming, one of my favorite MCU films as well. Then we have Thor Ragnarok, probably one of the funniest MCU films. Then we come to my personal favorite, Captain America Civil War. Black Panther on the 4K Steelbook, such a great film. Avengers Infinity War, also such a great film. And the most recent one, Ant-Man and the Wasp. Then we got Man of Steel on 4K. Batman v Superman, Dawn of Justice on 4K. Actually, I really love this movie. Not many people do, but it's really underrated in my opinion, especially the Ultimate Edition. Not perfect, but really good. Suicide Squad. Wonder Woman. Justice League. Batman Begins on Steelbook. Really, really great film. Honestly, this entire trilogy is just amazing. The Dark Knight in 4K. The Dark Knight, just regular Blu-ray, different covers, so I like the cover art, so I keep both of them. The Dark Knight Rises, lenticular slipcover, which is really cool. Batman The Dark Knight Returns Deluxe Edition. Watchmen, the director's cut, pretty underrated film. It's not perfect, but I actually enjoyed it. Alright, so for this next part, the tripod couldn't really fit in a great angle here. It's kind of big and clunky, and sorry about the glare on the lenticulars, but I got The Dark Knight Rises Digibook and Man of Steel Digibook. Then I got Arrow, the first season, the second and third season. First season's really good, the second one was decent, and the third one I actually didn't finish. I used to own all of them, but I sold the last two because I heard they were terrible. Batman, the anthology set, Returns Forever, and Batman and Robin. And then the first three seasons of The Flash, one of my favorite shows of all time. Then this is moving into the box sets. We have 2001 A Space Odyssey on 4K. This is one of my favorite films of all time. So incredible. Once you understand it, it's just amazing. I still don't understand it, and I love it. Then we have the Alien Anthology. Avatar, the extended cut. Back to the Future Trilogy. The Bridge on the River Kwai, that's a really nice box set. It's one of my favorite films of all time. In fact, I think it's like my second or third. It's such an incredible film. Casablanca, this is the Blu-ray disc set, the actual movie from the box set. Chariots of Fire Digibook. The Die Hard 4 film collection. I love all of those movies. I haven't seen the fifth one. I used to own it and I was going to watch it, but then I sold it because I heard it ruins the series, so I didn't go for it. 8 Days a Week, the Fast and Furious 8 movie collection, Gone Girl, this is a really nice box set and also one of my favorite films, Home Alone 1 and 2, The Hunger Games Deluxe Edition, The Indiana Jones Complete Adventures, Jurassic Park Ultimate Trilogy, Lost Season 1, Season 4, and Season 5, and It's a Mad, 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 Mad World on Criterion, really great comment. We got The Matrix Digibook, The Men in Black Trilogy on 4K, The Mission Impossible 5 Film Collection, North by Northwest, such a great film, Papillon, one of my all-time favorites. The Rocky Heavyweight Collection. I actually used to kind of like not like those movies, and now I love them, so it's cool. Shawshank Redemption on Digibook, amazing, one of my favorites. The Social Network, kind of like cool box set, amazing film. Aaron Sorkin's script is absolutely brilliant. The Spectacular Spider-Man Complete Series, that's my childhood right there, and one of my favorite shows of all time. Star Trek, the 6-movie collection, the originals, and the Next Generation collection. Decent films. The Star Trek trilogy, the J.J. Abrams movies. Taxi Driver, one of my favorite movies of all time. This is kind of like a digibook, but not really. It's really cool. Then we got Titanic, amazing film. Wild Strawberries, this is my first and only Ingmar Bergman film. I'll definitely try to check out more of his work. Then we got X-Men, the Wolverine Collection. We got Wyatt Earp and the Assassination of Jesse James, double feature. Then we got The Searchers, How the West Was Won, and The Wild Bunch, triple feature pack. Another triple feature pack, The Matrix Trilogy. Unforgiven and The Outlaw Josie Wales. Terminator 2 and Total Recall. Two Guns, decent cop movie, pretty funny. Three Games to Glory, Patriots, amazing. Used to be my favorite film of all time, 310 to Yuma on Blu-ray, and then of course, the 4K movie was really special to me, still is, got me in the film. We have The Seventh Voyage of Sinbad, really great older film, one of my favorites from my childhood. 8 Mile, amazing. 13 Hours, the Benghazi story. 21 Jump Street. 22 Jump Street, I actually like this one better. Really great comedies. 42, the Jackie Robinson story. 500 Days of Summer. The Accountant. Air Force One. Ali. Alien Covenant, really underrated in my opinion, one of my favorites of the series. Ridley Scott knocked it out of the park with that one in my opinion. American Graffiti, American Made, Apocalypse Now, I need to rewatch this one for sure, I've been craving it. Apollo 13, Argo, Arrival, Baby Driver, one of my favorites. Bad Boys 1 and 2, the 4K Steelbook Collection, those are also some of my favorite comedies, especially the second one. A Beautiful Mind, such a great film. Big, classic. Birdman. The original Blade Runner, and the far superior sequel in my opinion, Blade Runner 2049, both two of my favorite films of all time. Blood Diamond, really great film. Bone Tomahawk. Continuing on, we have Braveheart, a really great film. The Breakfast Club, one of my all-time favorites. Brothers. Bullet. Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid. The Butler. Captain Phillips. Casino Royale, one of my favorite movies of all time and a really nice steelbook. Castaway. Catch Me If You Can. Central Intelligence, a really underrated comedy in my opinion. Christmas Story, one of my favorites. Christmas Vacation, also one of my favorites. Chronicle, interesting movie, probably going to rewatch it soon. Clear and Present Danger. Close Encounters of the Third Kind, classic. Coach Carter. Collateral with Tom Cruise. Concussion. The Conspirator. Cool Hand Luke, really need to rewatch this, didn't get it as a kid. Courage Under Fire, Cowboys and Aliens, super underrated, trust me, give it a watch, despite the stupid title, it's such an incredible film. Crazy Stupid Love, one of my favorite comedies. Creed on 4K. The Curious Case of Benjamin Button on Criterion. Daddy's Home. Dances with Wolves. Daredevil, the director's cut. The Dark Tower, underrated in my opinion, I actually enjoyed it. And Date Night with this cool lenticular slipcover. We got Dazed and Confused, a really great high school film, one of my favorites. Deadpool. Deepwater Horizon. Defiance. Deja Vu. Deliverance, really great film. The Departed, one of my all-time favorites. Despicable Me, probably, actually, this is my first Blu-ray. I even wrote my name on it. Diamonds Are Forever on Steelbook. Die Another Day, terrible Bond film, but it was like a dollar. Die Hard on Steelbook, amazing. District 9, I actually watched this last night and it was such an incredible film. Django Unchained. Don't Breathe. Donnie Darko, the Arrow Video release Steelbook. Dr. No, the first Bond film that started it all. Drive, one of my all-time favorite films ever. Dunkirk. Edge of Tomorrow. Elysium, really good in my opinion. Actually, I think it's great. I actually just watched it this morning as I'm filming this video. Really, really great movie. Elf on Steelbook, classic. Enemy, one of my favorites. Jake Gyllenhaal, I think it's Denis Villeneuve. I don't know, he's amazing. Equalizer on 4K, pretty underrated in my opinion. Escape Plan, also underrated. E.T. on Steelbook, classic. Exodus, Gods and Kings. The Expendables, it's alright. The much better sequel, The Expendables 2, this is actually really good. Faster, really underrated, such a great film. And The Fault in Our Stars. Oh, and there's one more here, I didn't see it. Ferris Bueller's Day Off. Then we got A Few Good Men, really great film. Fight Club, as of now, this is my favorite movie of all time. It's perfect, I have no flaws. The Fighter. The Firm with Tom Cruise, really good. First Reformed, such a chilling film, one of the best of the year. Flight. The Florida Project, this was recommended to me by my buddy Josh, really great film. Check out his channel, Everything Movies, I'll leave a link to it in the description. Forrest Gump. The Founder. From Russia with Love on Steelbook. Fruitvale Station, one of my all-time favorites. The Fugitive. Funny People. The Game, great David Fincher film. Game Night, amazing underrated comedy. Gangs of New York. Gattaca. Get Out. Get Smart. Gladiator. Glory. The Godfather. Ugh, classic. Still need to see the other two. Going. Alright, so sorry if the lighting has changed. I ran out of time. I was filming during the day and I had to go to work and I was also having technical difficulties, but I worked it all out. It's all good. But it is nighttime now, so the lighting might be a little different. I'm probably going to be shooting this over a couple days just because this takes a while to do. But without further ado, should we keep going? So then we have The Gray, Liam Neeson. Gridiron Gang, actually a pretty good sports movie. I went through a huge Dwayne Johnson phase. Grown Ups, kind of a guilty pleasure for me. Hacksaw Ridge, amazing. The original Halloween. Hancock, Hang 'em High. The Hateful Eight. Heat. Hell or High Water, an amazing film. Hercules on Steelbook, not a great film, not really sure why I have it. Hidden Figures. Hitch, super underrated comedy, just amazing in every sense of the word to me. As goes for this, Hostiles, no one talks about this and people need to, one of my favorites. Catching Fire, probably the best of the series. And then Mockingjay Part 1 and Part 2. Hunt for Red October on Steelbook, my favorite of the Jack Ryan movies thus far. The Hurt Locker. I Am Legend, great film. I, Robot. The Imitation Game, amazing. Inception, probably one of my favorite movies of all time. It's in my top 10 for sure. The Incredibles on 4K. Independence Day. Inside Man. Inside Out. Insomnia, really underrated. Interstellar on 4K and Interstellar on Steelbook. I got this from a fan. Really, really nice set. And The Italian Job on Steelbook. J. Edgar. Jack Reacher. Amazing film in my opinion. Jack Reacher, Never Go Back. A pretty disappointing sequel. Tom Cruise was still good though. Jackie, also, like Hidden Figures, it has a really nice opening slipcover. Interesting film, really well done. I can't see myself rewatching it though. Jaws, one of my all-time favorite films. It's a classic. Jerry Maguire, John Wick, and John Wick Chapter 2. These aren't 4K. I just took the 4K slipcovers, or swapped them, I should say. Joy, Jurassic World. I also can't wait for John Wick Chapter 3, Parabellum, I think that's what it's called. I saw the trailer. It was really good. I just wanted to add that. King Kong, Peter Jackson's masterpiece, among the Lord of the Rings movies. Kong Skull Island, it's a pretty okay film. King's Speech, Kingsman the Secret Service, I love this film to death. I hated the second one. Night and Day, Knowing, another shout out to my friend Josh for recommending this. This was a really surprising film, really well done. La La Land, one of my all-time favorites. The Last Samurai. This is such an underrated masterpiece. Yeah, I said masterpiece. Law Abiding Citizen, one of my favorites. It's super messed up, but it's perfect. If you love thrillers like Seven and Prisoners, this film is right up your alley. The Lego Movie. The Lego Batman Movie. Lion, one of the best films of, I think that was 2016, 2017, let me know in the comments. The Lion King with this gorgeous Disney slipcover, I love it. Live and Let Die. Logan, masterpiece. Lone Survivor. The Lovely Bones, really underrated. I have this Magnificent Seven, the remake, one of my favorite films, it's really good. I just have it because this part is getting ripped, so I just put it in like this to keep it protected. The original Magnificent Seven, far superior to the remake, but just a classic, and I do love the remake. It's really good. The Martian, Man from U.N.C.L.E., Guy Ritchie film. Matchstick Men, really underrated Ridley Scott film. I'm going to take that out. The Maze Runner. Maze Runner 2, The Scorched Trials. McFarland, USA. Mean Streets, Martin Scorsese classic. The Meg, this is a terrible movie, but a guilty pleasure for me. Minority Report on Steelbook, really nice Steelbook. Mission Impossible Ghost Protocol. Mission Impossible Rogue Nation, this is a gorgeous Steelbook. I absolutely love this thing. This is actually one of my first Steelbooks, and it's just one of my favorites. My favorite film of 2018, Mission Impossible Fallout. This movie was everything I wanted it to be and more. Moneyball with Brad Pitt. Monty Python and the Holy Grail. I've only seen this once, and I actually didn't really think it was that funny. I know it's a classic. I should probably rewatch it. The Monuments Men. Moonrise Kingdom, a Wes Anderson classic. Mr. and Mrs. Smith. Mrs. Doubtfire, The Nice Guys, Nightcrawler, amazing, amazing film, Jake Gyllenhaal is a god, No Country for Old Men, Nonstop, super underrated in my opinion, also underrated, Oblivion of Tom Cruise. I recognize that this film has flaws, they just don't bother me. I actually made a review of this with my buddy Josh from Everything Movies. Check him out. This is one of my favorite films of all time. Can't really explain it. It just feels perfect in every sense of the word to me. On Her Majesty's Secret Service Steelbook. Only God Forgives. A really good Nicholas Winding Refn film. The Other Guys. Kind of a controversial opinion, but this is my all-time favorite comedy. Everything about it just works. The first time I saw it, I wasn't huge on it. And then I rewatched it with a friend, and I just fell in love with it, and I've seen it about 5 times. Every time I hang out with friends, or I'm meeting someone new, or I'm with a girl, this is the movie we always watch, and it's perfect. I love it so much. The Outsiders. Pain and Gain. Passengers. Patriot Games. Almost said Patriot's Day. The Patriot on 4K, really great film. Here we go, Patriot's Day. the perks of being a wallflower. This is, if not my favorite film, one of them. It's such an incredible high school film. If you have not seen this, do yourself a favor and check it out. It's amazing. The first Pirates of the Caribbean, the Curse of the Black Pearl, kind of like the only good one in my opinion. The second one's not bad, but it really just goes downhill from the first one. The Pirates of the Caribbean, Dead Man's Chest. Pirates of the Caribbean at World's End. Pirates of the Caribbean on Stranger Tides. The only reason I own the last two is because I had a box set. And when I bought them as a kid, I had only seen the first one, and I was so excited to watch the rest, I just bought the whole box set. Because surely a movie with a great first movie, series with a great first movie couldn't possibly be bad, right? The Place Beyond the Pines, a really great film. Planes, Trains, and Automobiles, one of my other favorite comedies of all time, amazing film. Rise of the Planet of the Apes. Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, and my personal favorite of the trilogy, War for the Planet of the Apes. Really great films. Predator with Arnold Schwarzenegger on 4K. The first time I saw this, I wasn't big on it. Then I watched it again and I fell in love with it, and I've seen it multiple times since. The new Predator, I have seen this twice now, and I still stand by it not being a great film, but I still like it. Everyone gives it so much crap, saying it ruins the original and it's the worst of the series, and I completely disagree with that. I think it's a decent film, not incredible, but it's decent. The Predator triple feature, this is the original trilogy. My favorite by far is Predator 2. It didn't work for me at all. I honestly really hated it. Just not a great film. Predators, I actually liked. It's my second favorite in the Predator series, then the new The Predator and Predator 2. That's kind of like my ranking. The Prestige, amazing film. The Princess Bride. Prisoners, oh my gosh. I just watched this 2 days in a row, and it's incredible. My family loved it. I loved it. It's one of my favorites of all time. Prometheus. Psycho, Quantum of Solace on Steelbook, both Steelbooks obviously, A Quiet Place on 4K, one of the best and biggest surprises of 2018, Martin Scorsese's Raging Bull, such a great film, Rain Man with Tom Cruise and Dustin Hoffman, amazing, amazing film, Remember the Titans, Rescue Dawn. I need to check this one out. Again, I've already seen it, and I remember I wasn't crazy on it, but I also remember I got interrupted a ton when I was watching it that day, so maybe it's better than I remember it being. The Revenant, probably one of the most gorgeous films I've ever seen. Risky Business, if not my favorite, probably one of my favorite high school movies. Road to Perdition. Robin Hood with Russell Crowe. This movie is extremely underrated in my opinion. Everyone seemed to hate it. I loved it. It's been a favorite of mine for as long as I can remember. RoboCop, one of the first Blu-rays I bought. A really great film. That is not a great film. This is pure nostalgia. I don't know why I said that. It's an okay film. But I don't know. It's okay. It's a guilty pleasure. The Rock, really great film. I do mean that. Even though it's Michael Bay. Run All Night. The Rundown. Pretty good. Pretty good movie. The Sand Pebbles. Amazing. Older film. We have Sandlot. Saving Private Ryan on Steelbook. Seven. One of my all-time favorite films. 7 Pounds. Super underrated. Check it out. Sherlock Holmes. Stanley Kubrick's The Shining. Oh my gosh, this movie is just incredible. One of my favorite films of all time. Shutter Island, really great film, really creepy. Also really creepy, Signs, great film. Silence, with Martin Scorsese's dream, he said. The Silence of the Lambs, incredible. Sixth Sense, also incredible. Skyfall on Steelbook. Snitch. Source Code, really great Gyllenhaal flick. Southpaw, also really great Gyllenhaal. Spaceballs, pretty overrated in my opinion. I've seen it a couple times and it just kind of gets worse for me every time I see it. Spectre, Speed, really great film. War of the Worlds, Spider-Man, the original. This is probably my all-time favorite Spider-Man film. Pure nostalgia, but also just a really well-made film. Sam Raimi is incredible with what he did there. Spider-Man 2, this is actually the extended cut. I don't know if it says it anywhere. Yeah, right there. This is the extended cut, and it's really good. Spider-Man 2. The Amazing Spider-Man, my least favorite Spider-Man film of all time. Amazing Spider-Man 2, I actually dig this movie. It's got some problems, but it's not terrible. Definitely better than the original Amazing Spider-Man, in my opinion. Split on 4K. Spotlight, such a great film. Stand By Me, also incredible. The Phantom Menace on Steelbook. Attack of the Clones on Steelbook. Revenge of the Sith. I actually really dig this movie. It's pretty underrated in my opinion. The best of the prequels by far. Solo, A Star Wars Story on 4K. Rogue One, A Star Wars Story. Pretty underrated. I like it a lot. The original Star Wars, it's not called A New Hope, despite what George Lucas wants us to think. This is my favorite Star Wars film of all time. I absolutely love it. The Empire Strikes Back, so close to being as good as the original. Really great. Return of the Jedi, wasn't quite as good as I remembered it as a kid, but really great still. Force Awakens, actually my second favorite Star Wars film. I like it just a hair more than Empire. I know that's unpopular opinion, but I love it. The Last Jedi, super disappointing for me. Not terrible, just not great. The Sting. Stronger, Jake Gyllenhaal, amazing. Sully. Super Bad, one of the best comedies I've ever seen. Taken, the extended director's cut, really great stuff there. The original Terminator, my favorite Terminator film. Thunderball on Steelbook, really great Bond film. Top Gun, this movie is purely just a amazing, I don't know, I'm a huge Tom Cruise fan. I'm obsessed with the guy. And this is a really, if you love Tom Cruise, this is definitely a movie for you. The Towering Inferno, a great older film. Transformers, the first one, the second one, Revenge of the Fallen, and let's see, this Dark of the Moon, it's got like a sticky thing on it so it sticks to stuff. The only reason I own those is I kind of went through a depressing phase and I ended up buying a bunch of Michael Bay movies, so you know I hit rock bottom when you're buying Michael Bay movies. I went after through like a breakup and stuff and it was rough, but we're out of it, so it's okay, it's okay. Tropic Thunder, amazing comedy. Trouble with the Curve. True Grit. True Grit, the remake, really great. I love it more than the original. Unbreakable, Shyamalan's subtle masterpiece. Unbroken on Steelbook, really underrated film. Unforgiven on 4K, excellent film. United 93. Unstoppable. Valkyrie, one of Tom Cruise's most underrated films. I love it to death. Vantage Point. Walking Tall with The Rock. And here we are on the last shelf. It's too low for me to film, so I'm going to be holding it because my tripod doesn't go this low, so I'm hand-holding it. So let's do it. We got Waterworld. Whiplash on Steelbook. Amazing film. The Wild Bunch, Director's Cut. The Wolf of Wall Street, just incredible. Woodlawn, True Story, pretty good film. World Trade Center, one of my favorites. World War Z, pretty good Brad Pitt world or zombie flick. X-Men Last Stand on Steelbook. X-Men Days of Future Past, almost my favorite X-Men film. Logan takes the cake for that. X-Men Apocalypse. Not huge on that. You Only Live Twice. And Zodiac. That is it, guys. I'll show you. The rest of these are all DVDs, as you can see. I will show you my collection downstairs that I haven't seen right now. Alright guys, we are currently in my basement and my tripod yet again was not tall enough, so I'm just going to go through handheld. We have 12 Years a Slave, Alfred Hitchcock, the complete masterpiece collection, Band of Brothers. I'm watching this with my dad. The way this is set up real quick is that this section here is all movies I'm watching with my family and like my dad and stuff. And then these movies here are movies I'm just watching on my own and working my way through slowly. So here we got the original Ben-Hur. Can't wait to watch this. Want to so bad. The Big Short. I really want to see it. Born on the 4th of July. I need to see Oliver Stone, more of his films. Boyhood. I've heard great things and terrible things, so I'm really not sure what to expect on that one. Clockwork Orange. I need to see it. Kubrick is one of my favorite directors of all time. The Deer Hunter. I've heard amazing things. Fiddler on the Roof. I'm not huge into musicals, but La La Land changed my perspective, so I'm open to them now, which is cool. And I've since found movies of musical genre that I actually love a lot. So, Full Metal Jacket, again, Kubrick, need to see it. The Godfather, Part 2. And The Godfather, Part 3. I've heard really bad things and really good things, but mostly bad. Hoping for the best. Gone with the Wind, it won Best Picture. I've heard it's really long, so I'm hoping I'll like it. Midnight Cowboy on Criterion. This is a really nice Criterion release. I actually got it really cheap. It was like 10 bucks used, so really glad I have that. One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. Some say it's Nicholson's best performance, along with The Shining. Panic Room. This is actually a DVD, but I needed to complete my Fincher collection. I own all of David Fincher's films, and Panic Room only was released on DVD and not Blu-ray for some reason. I really need to see it, though, soon. Platoon. Heard amazing things again, Oliver Stone. Then down here, these ones are just kind of balancing here, but I got the Rambo Complete Collection with Sylvester Stallone, Schindler's List, and Training Day. The only reason I haven't seen Schindler's List yet is because I've heard it's a masterpiece, of course, but I've heard it's super depressing, and I love depressing films, but I've heard this is like just depressing beyond depressing beyond depressing. So I'll definitely get to it eventually. All right, so here we are moving into now my section, just movies that I need to. I was gonna say get off my butt and watch, but I really need to just sit down and watch. We got All Quiet on the Western Front, one of the probably the earliest film I have in my collection. I've actually started this 3 times, and not to the film's fault at all. It's not boring, but I keep falling asleep during it. I feel really bad because it's not that it's slow. It's just every time I attempt to watch this, it's like I'm overtired, and it's actually really annoying. Bridge of Spies. We got Casino. My arm is blocking the light, but whatever. We're almost there, guys. We got Chappie on Steelbook. I got this from the fan mail from a viewer. Thank you very much. Children of Men on Steelbook. Crimson Tide. Expendables 3. I've actually bought like the entire Expendables trilogy all at once, and I watched the first one, and I really didn't like it that much, so I waited a while. And then a couple days ago, I watched the second one, and I liked it. So I'll probably watch this one soon. I'm not expecting much, though, because they lowered it to PG-13, and one of the things that was cool. But the other ones is they were really bloody and hard R's, and I don't know, they were, like, fun, you know? So then we got For Your Eyes Only on Steelbook. Foxcatcher. The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo. Fincher. I need to see it. I love you, Fincher. Inglourious Basterds. Tarantino. Lonesome Dove, this is a mini-series I really want to watch. I'm really into Western, so it's right up my alley. Mud with Matthew McConaughey, heard it's great. The Ocean's 11 trilogy. So Ocean's 11, 12, and 13, I have seen the first one, and kind of similar to All Quiet on the Western Front, I've started 12 like 3 times, but not falling asleep, something always just comes up and I get interrupted, and I've just been discouraged to try to finish it, so I'll watch it eventually for sure. But my goal is by the end of the year to have all of these gone, and I'm not buying any more movies unless it's a special occasion before I get through all these movies on my shelf. Then we got Planet Earth on Blu-ray. Looks really good. Cool documentary. Scarface with Al Pacino. Can't wait to watch that one. Sherlock Holmes, Game of Shadows, the second one. And then another Kubrick film. I gotta catch up on my Kubrick. Spartacus with Kirk Douglas, one of the first epics. Sum of All Fears. Still have to watch that. I think I've seen that a while ago when I was a kid, but I can't remember. So I need to rewatch it. So technically I'm saying I haven't seen it, but I think I have. Terminator 3, Rise of the Machines. It's weird. Every time I want to watch that, I always want to just binge the entire series. So I've seen the first two in preparation for watching the third one probably about four or five times each. And then I hear bad things about three and four, and I just lose interest in watching them. So I'm just going to have to watch them one of these days. Terminator Salvation. Tora. One of the, I think it's from the 70s, World War II film about Pearl Harbor. Total Recall, the remake. I've heard this is terrible, but I picked it up for really cheap, and I really liked the original Total Recall with Schwarzenegger. Transformers Age of Extinction. I already explained myself for owning Transformers movies. Not proud. And last but not least, When Harry Met Sally. I haven't seen it, like everything else on this shelf, but I've heard great things, so I'm excited. So without further ado, thank you so much for watching, and let's cut back to me ending this video. Hey guys, so sorry this part is not a tripod or anything. I've just been moving stuff around in my room and it's really messy, and there's no really like good way to get this angle without showing you guys how disgusting my room looks right now. But anyway, thank you so much for watching this video. 2018 was an absolutely crazy year for me, and I know 2019 will be as well. I can't wait to share it with you guys. So thank you so much for watching, and as always, if you had any comments, questions, ideas, absolutely anything, just leave it in the comments section down below. I always get back to you guys, and make sure to subscribe for more awesome content. That way I can see you guys soon. Peace.